DZMJ, right now we are here to interview regarding the preparation of ASEAN Summit here in the country, hosted by our Secretary of the Department of Science and Technology, no other than Fortunato de la Paña. Yes, good day, Secretary.
Hey, we are the country that is hosting the 75th ASEAN Meeting of Science and Technology Meeting, and this will be held in Cebu. The Philippines, of course, is chairing the meeting, and tomorrow, after the meeting was yesterday and today, and tomorrow it will be the informal meeting of Ministers of Science and Technology, which I am going to chair.
For the 10 decades of the meeting of IAMMST or this informal, can you give us or enlighten our viewers regarding this ministerial meeting of science committee?
Well, first of all, we will take stock of what has been happening regarding the implementation of the so-called PASTI plan, you know, or the ASEAN Plan of Action for Science and Technology. Actually, so to take stock on what has been happening, because the plan, the new plan started in 2016 up to 2025, 10-year plan. So I suggest that we take a look, since 2 years have already passed. I think we will see what has been done as far as the plans contained there are concerned. Secondly, I also would like to get information, of course, requesting the countries who have pledged support to ASEAN, to the ASEAN Committee on Science and Technology. Let me enumerate the countries that have committed support. When I came in 2016, during the first IAMMST meeting I attended, I learned that Thailand has already pledged $1 million US dollars to fund collaborative research. Okay? That was, there were no details about it. But during that meeting, when I learned about it, I decided to also make an announcement that the Philippines is pledging $1 million US dollars in support of training and also scholarships, particularly for the less for the developing ASEAN member states, so Myanmar,
the Cambodia, and the Laos.
And of course, we also accommodated participants from other member states, but of course, mas marami yung sa CNLV. So, for example, I think we held as many as 6 to 7 training programs in very specific areas, like on LIDAR, on the newest packaging technologies, on the operation of food innovation centers.
Our FIC.
Our FIC. On, there was also a training that has something to do with, I think, Pedro, the receiving stations for satellite information. And there were two others that was very, very well attended. In addition, we were able to accommodate 18 scholars. Most of them are in the MS level, but there are also some PhD, and these were coming from Cambodia, Laos, and Myanmar.
Most of them in the China area.
Oh, oh. And of course, they have to study here. The scholarship conditions that they have to study at a university in the Philippines. So many have chosen UP Los Baños, UP Manila,
the UP system.
So, of course, La Salle was included. And I'm not sure whether there were some UST, but we had scholars in UP Manila, because some of these scholars were in the medical field. And this was very, very well appreciated. In fact, when the Cambodian senior minister came over, the equivalent of the prime minister, and made a conscious call from Netanyahu, I was told by the president to attend also to the medical field. by Cambodians. So now, many of them are, well, we are supporting them up to graduation. Now, actually, the $1 million that we raised has been consumed. Pero siyempre, naka-save na yung para makatapos yung ongoing. But I intend to make another new commitment to continue scholarships. Maybe not necessarily to the training programs, but more to the scholarships.
The postgraduate for the country.
So I might not mention any dollar figure, but they can mention the number of stats that we can offer. So I intend to probably commit at least 10 more scholarships, or maybe as many as 18, just like what we
the first.
And of course, we would like to know what happened to the $1 million in Thailand, the $1 million in Singapore, that they pledged, kasi last year, after knowing that Philippines and Thailand and Philippines pledged $1 million, last year, three countries pledged the $1 million. These were Singapore for researches, I think, in selected areas, I think related to artificial intelligence.
Oh, the AI!
If I'm not mistaken. then, Malaysia committed $1 million for research also. And then, Indonesia pledged also $1 million for research, but not specified. Mas maganda po na specified the areas. So we would like to know what has been done as far as these pledges
the monitoring.
Hopefully the kind of collaboration that we continue with this kind of support member states. Okay? So parang among the original members, silang nag-pledge.
Reason point.
Okay, so the other things that we would like to take up would be summary arrangements on the member states who will be in charge of the third country partners. Diba? We partner with the US, we partner with the
Japan,
the European Union.
EU, okay. There are those that partners also, but not so active, you know. But the US is active, Japan is active, the EU is active. I think Canada is also. So we are trying to, China is also trying to reassign the states who will be taking care of the US. Or the other
part of Asia.
So that. At least naman, marotate yung Then, we also would like to discuss how we will sort of operationalize the ASEAN Declaration on Innovation. Because during the summit here last November, the proposed ASEAN Declaration on Innovation was adopted. We are proud to say that the Philippines was the one who initiated having an ASEAN Declaration on Innovation. And of course, the DOST ASEAN, which led, we went through a process, you know, because before everyone agrees on the declaration, it takes time, and several iterations, until finally it was agreed upon by all 10 member states.
The Philippines initially convinced them for that declaration.
So it was discussed during the ASEAN post meetings.
Part of which Joseph Ibarra
chair. Oh, during this time. So we will have to find out and agree how do we operationalize the declaration. There are other items that I think most of them are actually follow up on. as I have been on the so I want to know what's the status of collaborative projects.
So from using Ibarra Chair for the COS meeting, after the COS meeting?
They will present the results of the COS meeting to the ministers. Of course, we will sort of determine which ones we will focus on in the discussion. So others will be for information only. Others will require discussion. Others will require decision.
So for that ministerial meeting, which will be the final decision for the execution of the Asian
the plans that we have.
Plans until 2020.
The committee can decide, but simply it is better to have the affirmation of the ministers.
And we are in light regarding this upcoming ministerial meeting here in the Philippines, Cebu, of course, with Secretary Fortunato Villapena being chair for that ministerial meeting and hosted by the Philippines. This is MJ Albina Balibre on DZMJ Online. Makabuluhang Jordan.